SpaceX has set the stage for a record-breaking Starship booster static fire, after the rocket completed a complex fueling test and launch rehearsal, earlier this week. Hello and welcome to another episode of Science of Space. Starship Super Heavy set the stage for its most awaited test of the year. On January 25, a tower the size of a skyscraper, activated a pair of giant mechanical arms, to disassemble the largest rocket ever built. The arms carefully grabbed Starship using hard points, under its flaps, and lifted the 50-meter-tall second stage and spacecraft off of Super Heavy Booster 7. On January 26, SpaceX transported Ship 24 back to its Starbase, Texas factory for finishing touches. Booster 7 remained installed on Starbase's donut-shaped orbital launch mount, which uses clamps and umbilicals to hold Starship in place and power, fuel, and pressurize Super Heavy. In theory, the next time Booster 7 leaves that launch mount, it will do so under its own power. But first, SpaceX must ensure that that unprecedented power can be controlled and survive. This, unfortunately, is far from the first iteration of this story. SpaceX has been seemingly close to the milestone, at many points over the last year and a half. In September 2021, for example, CEO Elon Musk reported that Super Heavy Booster 4 would attempt the first static fire on Starbase's orbital launch mount later that month. 11 months later, Super Heavy Booster 7 gave the ULM its inaugural static fire test, albeit with just one of its 33 engines. In the months following that static fire, Booster 7 completed another single-engine test, a two-engine test, a 7-engine test, a 14-engine test, and a long-duration 11-engine test. All of that slow and steady testing has been fairly successful, and caused no major damage to the rocket or pad. But 5 months after it began, SpaceX has never ignited more than 14.42% of Super Heavy's 33 Raptor engines at once. That must change before SpaceX can gain enough confidence in Starship, and convince the FAA to license an orbital launch attempt. During Super Heavy B7's 14-engine static fire, the booster could have produced up to 3,220 tons of thrust. When it ignites all 33 available engines for the first time, its maximum thrust could leap to 7,590 tons. Beating the next most powerful rocket in history, the Soviet N-1 by nearly 60%. In other words, SpaceX will be attempting something unprecedented in rocketry. Success is far from guaranteed, and the worst possible failure mode could almost entirely destroy Starship's only finished orbital launch site, explaining SpaceX's unusual caution. On January 23, Ship 24 and Booster 7 completed Starship's first full wet dress rehearsal, a fueling and launch rehearsal test. On the first try, an extremely impressive achievement for any rocket, let alone the largest in history. With that combined test out of the way, the only unprecedented test standing between Starship and its first orbital launch attempt is a 33-engine Super Heavy static fire. To reduce risk, Ship 24 was removed from Booster 7. Back at the factory, SpaceX needs to close a few gaps left in its heat shield, and will likely also conduct careful inspections to ensure that the Starship is ready for flight. Unburdened of Ship 24, Booster 7 may finally be on the cusp of the most challenging ground test in Starship and SpaceX history. SpaceX has scheduled 12-hour road closures that could be used for that purpose as early as February 3 and February 5. Those road closures could be used for Ship 25 static fire testing instead of or in addition to Booster 7. The Super Heavy is also missing an important hydraulic power unit that was removed before the wet dress rehearsal. It's unclear if static fire testing can be conducted without that HPU, one of two, why it was removed, or how long replacing it will take, adding more uncertainty. Nonetheless, it still appears that SpaceX is no more than a few weeks away from Starship's first 33-engine static fire attempt. Only by late 2022 did Ship 24 more or less complete proof testing, and Booster 7 is still several major tests away from solidifying full confidence in its design. SpaceX has conducted almost all testing with fully stacked Starships, further increasing the amount of confidence the company can have in the assembled rocket. Lacking the data needed to know with certainty whether the tweaked designs of Starship and Super Heavy are good enough for several orbital test flights. It's thus unsurprising that SpaceX only produced a handful of usable ships and boosters in 2022. But if CEO Elon Musk's forecast is correct, the company has plans to increase Starbase's useful output in 2023. According to Musk, SpaceX aims to build about 5 full stacks this year, translating to 5 flightworthy Starships and 5 Super Heavy boosters. In 2022, SpaceX finished Booster 7 and built Booster 8, Booster 9, and most of Booster 10. Booster 8 was almost immediately relegated to the retirement yard. Booster 9, featuring some significant design changes, completed a limited amount of proof testing and returned to the factory in early January, likely for Raptor engine installation. The fate of Booster 10 is unclear, but it stands as a prime example of how fast SpaceX can actually build massive Starship hardware when conditions are right. SpaceX began stacking B10 in late October 2022, and the vehicle is just 2 stacks away from full height 3 months later. In the same period, SpaceX finished an immediately retired Starship S-22, finished and began testing Ship 24, finished and began testing Ship 25, and finished stacking Ship 26. Booster 9's upgrades partially insulate it from the most disappointing possible scenario, retirement before flight. Even if Booster 7 fails during pre-launch testing or its launch attempt, revealing major design flaws, it's possible that Booster 9's changes have already addressed those weaknesses, allowing it to continue the flight test campaign. Ship 25's fate is even more dependent on the fate of Ship 24. In terms of useful output, that manufacturing slowed down a bit in 2022. That slowdown can likely be partially explained by the need to move equipment and processes into the first finished section of Starfactory. But in general, SpaceX was simply focused on finishing and testing Starship S-24 and Super Heavy B-7. Both stages of the latest vehicle meant to attempt Starship's first orbital launch. Only by late 2022 did Ship 24 more or less complete proof testing, and Booster 7 is still several major tests away from solidifying full confidence in its design. SpaceX conducted full-stacked wet dress rehearsal testing with fully stacked Starships, further increasing the amount of confidence the company can have in the assembled rocket. Lacking the data needed to know with certainty whether the tweaked designs of Starship and Super Heavy are good enough for several orbital test flights. It's thus unsurprising that SpaceX only produced a handful of usable ships and boosters in 2022. But if CEO Elon Musk's forecast is correct, the company has plans to increase Starbase's useful output in 2023. According to Musk, SpaceX aims to build about 5 full stacks this year, translating to 5 flightworthy Starships and 5 Super Heavy boosters. Combined with the fact that no Super Heavy lift rocket in history has flown 5 times in its first year of launch activity, a trend Starship seems unlikely to break. SpaceX could practically halt production entirely in 2023, and still have a full year of testing ahead of it while only using ships 24 to 26 and boosters 7, 9, and 10. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.